So now let's look at what happens when we need to dispatch instructions. So this is the situation in a cycle. Dispatch basically needs to consider latching operations results that are produced and also deciding which instructions are ready to execute. So in the same cycle, usually we will have both of them. So we will consider a situation where we can actually kind of at the beginning of the cycle do this and then towards the end of the cycle actually choose among the instructions that are ready to go. None of these instructions are ready to go. So if we did it the other way around in this cycle, nothing would really dispatch. So now let's do it. What's going to happen is when we broadcast the result, we say which reservation station is producing the result and what the value is. And now what happens is this. The reservation station whose result is being broadcast, note that this reservation station has already dispatched this, it was executed, it was broadcast, etc. So now it comes back here. We're now gonna free this reservation station. Basically, it's finished its job. So the first thing we're gonna do is free this reservation station. Now it's empty and it's ready to receive another instruction that issues. The next thing that we're gonna do is match this tag against each of the two operands in each of the reservation stations. So what's going to happen is RS4 doesn't match, so we're not going to do anything for this. RS1 here does match, so instead of RS1 here, we are going to use the value of -0.29. For this instruction, it already has a value here, so we don't have to match anything, but RS1 here does match, so we're going to take the value of 0.29. And here we have another match of minus 0.29, and this value is already here. So this completes basically what happens when a result is kind of being broadcast as far as reservation stations are concerned. Now we need to consider which reservation stations have all of the operands ready to go. This one doesn't, this one does, and this one does. Because these are going to different execution units, assuming that in each execution unit can take one operation per cycle, this instruction, RS4, is gonna execute in the multiplier. So the multiplier for a while, it will be busy with the, you know, RS4, this is a divide, and it's gonna be basically doing this over this. And then here, this one is not ready to go, so the only one that can really go here is this one. So what we will be doing for a while is RS3, -0.29 plus 2.72. Once these are done, they're gonna broadcast the results and this cycle will repeat.